اسمع انا قاعد لا اشياء مسر شر اي اسك يو سم كويستشن ريجاردينج ذس ايجوكيشن سيستم توداي ذا كلاس بين وي ديليفر كلاس ان اون لاين كلاسز فيديو كلاسز كوميونيتي كلاسز ريفرنس كلاسز موستلي ذس ايجوكيشن سو فار از ايجوكيشن اكسبوزر ار كونسرن دي موستلي ستريس اون ذيس كوميونيتي كلاسز ذيس فيديو كلاسز اند ريفرنس كلاسز هاو كود ايت بي باسبل تو يوز ديجيتال ميديا ذس ذات از موبايل status or the computer system or other kinds of digital and digital education could provide or could provide benefit to the students when students are some students of this institution they are living in rural area they are so much so poor that they cannot afford a mobile set. I have also called a woman on a student on phone, but phone was received by her mother and his mother told me that he has now his own phone and this is the only phone which we have at home. In this respect, how could it be possible to convey education, to convey the benefits of this delivering classes, from very first up to class 12th, when these phones are not available to the students at home?
Yes, Dr. Bashir Ahmad Khan sir, it's a very serious issue because you know you are telling me that digital technology how it benefits us the education imparting education. It is definitely going to be a revolution in the field of education if this digital facilities are being properly utilized. Yes, this was already there. I mean, as a supporting factor, it was already there. But so far as COVID-19 is concerned, it has been widely used by most of the not only departments, by most of the faculties. But yes, there are many problems in using this, because if you expect that this can be used at primary level or middle level or secondary and higher secondary or college, yes, it can be used everywhere. But to me, it seems to be difficult so far. It can be used in the primary level or middle level, because in this age group, the students are coming from the villages, and you know those who are enrolled in government schools like primary school and middle schools, they don't have such facilities at home to get the benefit of these things. Yes, teachers do their best, whether they are doing their services in urban areas or rural areas. Yes, this is possibly it can have a good effect in urban areas, because there is there is facility to the every student, whether he is teaching in primary or elementary or secondary or higher secondary. But it is really a big concern in rural areas where students don't have such facilities. But yes, again, I've been telling you that these things, these gadgets, like electronic gadgets vis-a-vis this smartphone, vis-a-vis projectors and other things, and they have been highly helpful in imparting education in an effective manner. And this has not only saved the time and energy, but the efforts have been properly, I mean, utilized both by the teachers and by the students.
Thank you. And one more question related to the same is that if the urban areas would get more benefits from this digital education, and the rural areas where the poor are living, poor would not get any benefit from these classes we use digital devices. Mm-hmm. And that means a time would come that only urban people would rule the whole community.
Yes, the experiences say, urban people are already taking advantage of everything. Mm-hmm. So digital technology too, in this field too, they can take the advantage. Yes, the students living in urban areas, they can be benefited much and much. But again, as the rural area students, they are always deprived from almost all the facilities. And again, this lacking of this facility can hamper their progress too. So I can say this is bad luck or unfortunate for these students for not having such facilities. Otherwise, they too can shine like the students living in the urban areas.
Thank you. One more question is that students of rural areas, they have the devices, they have different kinds of devices, electronic media, and they use this media for for receiving classes, for getting benefits from the digital media. But there are only poor students, about 50% of students which are in our classes, they are from poor families and could not afford the mobile sets. And as such, only these highly placed people could get the benefits of receiving kalashes from this digital media. And that means the poor would remain always poor, and rich people would go high.
Yes, Dr. Saab, it has being rich is always a blessing, and being poor is always a curse. As you know, here we can see how way the students belonging to the rich communities, they are being benefited, and they enjoy all the things around them. And in this COVID, we have seen that they have enjoyed even this digital technology to a greater extent, and they have excelled too much. But again, poor have been deprived, poor students. I myself, being the teacher, I have contacted so many students, but when I tried to contact them, their phone was with their parents who was working either with NALA or as a laborer somewhere. Unfortunately, to say that this has been a great hurdle in the process of learning for poor is very unfortunate for them.
One more question, that's last question to you, is that I have seen a cartoon in a newspaper. There is a father and his child. The child was asking his father, "Daddy, what do you mean by schooling? What do you mean by school?" And is it not true that if this compulsive environment would continue, if the viral multiplication it would continue, would it not be that the new generation coming forward, new generation, the new born, they are go after six or seven, if it will go up to 7 or 10 years, there would be no concept of this education in school or schooling?
Of course, I have a strong fear. I believe that over a period of time, this digital technology can replace the traditional system. As you are talking about the school is all important, Dr. Saab, I'm telling you again, because Allama Iqbal has once somewhere written in his poetry, Sheikh Maktab hai ek imarat gar jiski sanad hai ruhi insani. To ye jo Sheikh Maktab school hai, it has got its important role. To be in the school is a great deal, always, it can benefit a lot. To be in the virtual mode is, yes, you can be more informative, but it cannot help you to a greater extent. It is really a big concern in the future that the students may forget about the schools, and it would be quite highly unfortunate.
Thank you for having this helpful interaction. And there is an ad before us, this paper, read something and read it and go through. Thank you for this healthy interaction. Very much. Thank you.